Welcome inside Dodger Stadium here in Los Angeles. A good one on tap for you this afternoon between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Houston Astros. Major League Baseball on the show is next. Now at the plate here is Austin Meadows, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2. Should be a picture-perfect afternoon for baseball. 78 degrees at first pitch. And they'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Rays DH.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Good change up in the dirt, strike three. Throw to first is in time, one down. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Brandon Lau. 1-1. High in the air out to center field. Strong is in his tracks now, and he's got it for out number two. So two out, nobody on, and up next will be Randy Arozarena. Now the 1-1 pitch. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. And it's fouled away. Just underway here in Southern California. Fouled off. High chopper to third. Bregman gloves it. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Here comes the second baseman, Jose Altuve, to get things kicked off in the home half of inning number one. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve.
Two balls, one strike.
Hard hit ball to second. Throw to first is in time for the first out. So one down, no one aboard. And that'll bring up Alex Bregman.
Bregman.
Up high, 2-1 now.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
He's set. Here's the 3-1. And he missed with that one. It's ball four. A one-out walk here in the home first.
That is third.
And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. His previous meeting line with Tyler Glasnow. He's 0 for 8. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time. Out number two. So two down and a runner at first. And the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. Breaking ball that misses out of the zone. Correa in front, three balls and a strike.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm in the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
Fouled away. Payoff pitch one more time. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap.
Gone!
So now to the plate, Yordan Alvarez. Line drive, base hit. So the bottom of the inning is still alive after the two-out base hit. the tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. Into the box, and Choi. Just off the inside part of the plate, it's 3-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
And that misses for ball four, so it's a leadoff walk here to start the second. And that'll bring up Manuel Margot. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. From the belt, kicks and deals.
Choi
gets his lead at first, nobody out. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2. And boy, that misses as well. It's back-to-back walks to start out the inning. Up next for the Rays, Joey Wendell. A 1-1 home, taking a strike two.
Hey, looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Here's the 1-2. And this is on the ground is short. Could be two. Altuve for one. On the first, but not in time as he beats it out. Next, it'll be Willie Adames. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. So next to bat will be Kevin Kiermaier. Greinke over to first, and the runner back easily. Runners at the corners, two men out. No offer on that one, two balls and a strike.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Now he turns on a fastball and sends it deep down the right field line. And this will get over the wall, in fact, so just the one run will be allowed to score. Stepping in now, Mike Zunino. A 1-2 count to the Rays catcher. And he fouls this one off. The set and the 1-2. Slider whiffed on for strike three. A great pitch to put an end to the inning. So here's Yuli Gurriel. His previous meeting line with Tyler Glasnow. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. Here's the 1-1. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Fielded cleanly. And the inning begins with a quick out number one. Driving in for Houston, Kyle Tucker. One out, nobody on. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. Here's the 3-1. Now a fastball swung on and missed in its full 3-2.
Woo-wee.
That was some smoke right there. High fire right on by.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. Now at the plate, Miles Straw. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. The 3-2 pitch. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
The catcher.
Now to the plate, Jason Castro. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away.
I got two on the count.
Did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Adames picks it up. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Back to the top of the order now, and Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. Popped up. And there's out number one. Striding in is Brandon Lau. A 2-1 score here as we play inning number three. On the ground up the middle, scooped up. Throw on to first is in time, and Grinke's got himself two outs. Here's Randy Arozarena, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a miss. Good sinking action there. 1-2. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
That's his first base hit, making 1-for-2 now.
Now batting, the first baseman, G-Man.
Into the box now, G-Man Choi. Strike taken, the throw. And he is out at second. Caught stealing to end the inning. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Jose Altuve. And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third. So now here is Alex Bregman. He reached on a walk in his last time up and later came around to score. In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. The 2-2 is looked at and the count moves full.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Swing and a flare hit toward right. Margo is in a few steps as he takes it for the first down. One out now in the Houston third. And that brings in the left-handed hitting outfielder, Michael Brantley. Here comes the 2-1 to Brantley. There he goes. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Two down with a runner at first. Ambling over to the batter's box is Carlos Correa.
Well, Matt, this is one of the problems. This guy's a good fastball, particularly low fastball hitter. It doesn't matter how hard or how low you throw it. That's right into this wheelhouse. What you want to do with this guy is move the ball from the belt up to get him to chase something that maybe he'll pop up in the infield.
Two balls and two strikes now. Here now the 2-2. Pitch is high. The throw is not close as he's in there with a stolen base. He set the payoff pitch. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes.
If I'm standing on the mound right now, I'm not feeling too confident about where I'm locating my baseball. If it's getting pushed out for power the other way, you would have to think he's going to have
it. And the catcher grabs it to retire the side. The inning is over. Set for the start of the fourth, and next to bat will be the first baseman, G-Man Choi. Back up the middle, and a base hit, so early trouble to lead off the inning. In now, Manuel Margo. Breaking ball called just a bit low.
Ball three.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in this zone, or do you just pitch around them?
3-2 pitch.
Nope, that's down.
And he will take ball four. First and second now with nobody out. Joey Wendell digs in now. A base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. 2-2. And he tried to hold up that time. We'll get an appeal down to third, and no swing. It's ball three. Working for the punch out and the offering. And it's fouled away. He's set. Here's the 3-2. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. The next 3-2. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out. Up next, Willie Adames trying to bring in the tying run from third here. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And he comes back with a pitch right down the middle for strike two.
Got to think he was sitting fastball right there to let that hanger go by. He won't see that pitch again the rest of the season.
One there, but the return throw will be too late, and the run is in to score. On to first, but not in time. It's a fielder's choice and an RBI. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. Two runs, three hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
All even now, 2-2.
He's got a good feel for his off-speed pitches second time through the order, and we just saw three in a row.
Still 2-2. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. Now this is hit not all that hard out to second. And indeed, he'll take only the out at first as the run comes in to score. Here now is Mike Zunino, struck out in his first at-bat.
And you can live with punching out with the bases empty, but in his last at-bat with two runners in scoring position, you cannot go down not putting the ball in play. Too much on the line, too many ribby opportunities out there to swing and miss in that spot.
And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in is the DH, Yordan Alvarez. The 3-1 is in there for strike number two. Good battle. Count remains full. He's set. Here's the 3-2. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. A Rosarena arranged to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down. Next up for the Astros, Yuli Gurriel. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Popped him up. Zunino has a play. He's got it, and there are two down now. And stepping in, Kyle Tucker looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
The 2-1 home. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. So Tampa's batting order turns over and set to go. Austin Meadows, no hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. And he lays off again, ball three.
It's one thing to get hit around, but it's far worse when you're getting yourself into trouble by not throwing strikes.
Big swing, and this one's launched to right field and deep. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone, a home run. Standing in now, Brandon Lau. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1.
All the makings of a big inning right here. One already left a yard, and the power hitters are coming up.
Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Here now the 2-2. This is on the ground over to first. Gurriel scoops it up, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. No one on with one down, and up next will be Randy Arozarena. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Brantley is under it. He's got it, and there are two down now. G-Man Choi the next to hit. He scored after knocking a single in his last at bat. The 1-1 home. Doesn't catch the outside corner. It's a ball. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Here now the 2-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And digging in is the outfielder, Miles Straw.
This is where the pressure starts to build a little bit on an offense. It's not late enough. I mean, you don't have to start panicking right now, but this is where you're looking for someone to light a spark to get back in this game.
Throws in time, and that's out number one. So now into the box is Jason Castro. 4-2 our score here as we play inning number five. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Now here's the pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. So two are gone for the Astros in the fifth. And striding in, the speedy second baseman, Jose Altuve. Count remains 2-2. Breaking ball, and he gets him to chase it in the dirt. Zunino has it, and the throw to first ends the inning. Joe Smith takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 38.
All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring up the versatile center fielder Manuel Margot. This is on the ground over to first. Gurriel brings it in. And he'll step on first for the out. Three unassisted. And that'll bring up Joey Wendell. The 3-1. Lined is short, but gobbled up there, and there are two away. So two outs now in the Tampa Bay sixth. And up next will be Willie Adames. A ball and two strikes to the Rays shortstop. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Colin McHugh enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 31.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and set to go is the third baseman, Alex Bregman. Now the 1-1 pitch.
count.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
Fouled off. Line drive, base hit. Throw into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two base hit.
The left fielder, number 23, Michael Brantley.
At the plate now, Michael Brantley. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
Kiermaier coming on. He gets there and makes the play for the first down. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base.
The batter, number one.
Runner at second, one away. And the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. Fly ball right down the line and left. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well three times in a row with off speed.
Now a flare out to left center. Adames ranges back and he has it for out number two. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. A hit in two tries so far. Three hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Now this ball popped up. Playable, however, behind the plate for Zunino. And he'll get under it to put it away in foul territory, and that ends the inning. Blake Taylor is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
For the Astros, number 62.
So here's Kevin Kiermaier, who grounded out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
To two balls and two strikes now. A full count to the Rays center fielder.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Fouled away. The next 3-2. And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
Next for Tampa Bay.
And now, Mike Zunino. The 3-1. And solid contact there as this ball is belted high in the air out to left. Not quite out of here. It's off the out-of-town scoreboard. Now the relay home. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score. At the plate, Austin Meadows. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Strong is there, and he has it for the first out. Now to the plate, here is Brandon Lau. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. The 1-1 home. Zunino, the runner at second with one away. Three and one now. Popped him up. Correa is there for it. And that's the second out of the inning. Stepping up is Randy Arozarena. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And it looks like they'd rather go after the next guy as the intentional walk signal comes here with two away.
The first baseman.
So here's the cleanup hitter, G-Man Choi. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. 1-1. and here's a drive. Well hit out to straightaway center. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. And the run will score all the way from first. It's a 7-2 ball game. Ryan Stanek will get the ball here as he looks to get the final out in the top of the seventh. To the plate now, Manuel Margot. And this will be fouled away. Three runs already home here. And a slider runs in on him as he has to lean out of the way.
Wow, kind of an interesting pitch call there. The batter flailed at the pitch away on the previous one, so you'd think you'd go right back there, but instead they decided to come in. Make him prove he can adjust before you do.
And he fouls this one off. Another full count pitch home. Started to go around, but it's a called third strike anyway, and that will retire the side. Last half of the seventh here, and here comes the first baseman, Yuli Gurriel. 1-1, here it comes.
Count is 2-1.
Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Here now the 2-2. Is swung on and missed, strike three. Next up is Kyle Tucker. He's 0-2 thus far in this one. McHugh's ready. Here's the 1-1. And he lays off the pitch down and away. Ball two.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
Left fielder is on the move. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. Into the box, Miles Straw. He's 0-1 thus far. One and two now. Two out, nobody on. And another foul ball. Here's another 1-2. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. In the eighth, and digging in next will be Joey Wendell. Swing and a miss on the splitter, and it's 1-2. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. Next to stand in is Willy Adames. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. Count still full, 3-2. Another full count pitch home. Fouled away. Full count still. And now this will be the 10th pitch of the at bat. Got him. And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Next to hit, Kevin Kiermaier. 1-2 with a double on his line thus far. 3-2 pitch. And he looks at ball four now. So he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base.
Mike.
The 3-1. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. Striding forward now is the DH, Austin Meadows. He went deep back in the fifth. And he gives this a pretty good ride that time, but that's going to be up amongst the crowd, a foul ball. Kiermaier on second, Zunino at first, two out in the inning. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. The next 1-2 pitch. Chases out of the zone for strike three, and that's the third out of the inning. Chaz Rome is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 50.
Now it'll be Jason Castro. He's hitless in his two at bats so far. Taken down and in for a ball.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood in a broken bat.
Struck him out, so he set down on strikes for the second time today. So the Houston lineup turns over and to the plate, Jose Altuve. Lifetime in this matchup. He's gone 4-for-9. And here's a pitch swung on and missed, 1-2 now.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two.
Third baseman number two.
And that'll bring up the Alex. Former first rounder Alex Bregman. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. 1-1 pitch and a good sinker there, but he can't find the zone. 2-1.
That's the heavy sinker right there. He has the ability to get ground balls when he needs them, potential double play situations, or to get that jam job with no one on base, that tapper right back to the pitcher. One of the toughest pitches to hit in the game.
Trying to strike out the side. Here it is. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Now at the plate is Brandon Lau, struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. The 1-1 home.
Nope, outside.
Swing, but a late one is fouled off to the left. Here now the 2-2. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
He's definitely going to want to get greedy in his zone, and he's obviously seeing the ball well.
Oh, hang on now. This ball is smoked to right, and I don't think this one's coming back. No chance. It's gone. So now to the plate, Randy Arozarena. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now. Popped him up. Gurriel over to his left, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Next will be the cleanup hitter, G-Man Choi. He drove in two runs on a double in his last at-bat.
Yeah, it's been an offensive explosion for him today. There's a fight at the bat rack. Everyone seems to be putting barrel on baseball in this lineup.
Bases are empty, one man out. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. A payoff pitch one more time. Lifted down the line and left. After it is Brantley. And foul.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
Slow little roller to third. Throw not in time, and he's in there with his third hit of the afternoon. Stepping in now, Manuel Margot. Fouled off. Just hung in there on that one. The 2-2 one more time. It's the top of the zone. He struck him out looking. Next up, Joey Wendell. He went down on strikes last time up. The 1-1. Choi is off of first with two away. Pulled toward right center field. Strong is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. Here's Michael Brantley, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. The 1-1. Popped up. And that's in there. Base hit. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And the Astros get something started right away. It's a leadoff double.
The batter, number one. Shortstop.
Into the box, Carlos Correa. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
And this is swung on and missed. And boy, they took care of a key man there. One away. Swing and a miss. And they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
The first baseman.
Now the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Last strike now for Houston. And this one's in the dirt. But it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Two out here and a runner at second. Now a swing and a fly ball. And this should do it. And that's going to fall for a base hit. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
The right fielder, number 30, Kyle.
At the plate now, Kyle Tucker. Now a line drive here is caught. And if that's not symptomatic of the way this one's gone, the ball game is over. 8-3 is today's final. Tampa Bay took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Tyler Glasnow pitches well enough to get the W. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
The final line score.